Hi guys, it's JLH here, and today I'm going to be doing an unpopular K-pop opinions video because I've never done this video in quite a bit of time, and I really love doing unpopular K-pop opinions videos because I have so many opinions and I try to keep my opinions as different as everyone else's because I see a lot of opinions that are the same on different channels when I look at K-tube, and there are very less opinions that are different from others, so I try to be different, and I hope that you are respectful in the comments and you don't bash me for any opinion, because these opinions are not made to trigger people. These are just opinions I like want to get out to the world and to the people subscribe to my channel, so that I can like share what I feel about the K-pop industry, and I can share my different opinions. So I hope you I hope you enjoy the video, and I hope you subscribe to me because I upload videos whenever I feel like it and whenever I want to. So I hope you enjoy, and let's go. So before I begin, I just wanted to say, for some opinions I added random performance in the background because I didn't know what videos to add for the opinion. So yeah, the first opinion for this video is not related to K-pop, but it's related to some K-tubers that I've seen. Like, I've seen a video called Blackpink Duru Duru Du, but it's reversed. Then I seen another video by another channel, those were two videos on their channel, which was Blackpink Lovesick Girls at 500% speed, Blackpink How You Like That at 500% speed, and those videos have all passed 300k views and is like close to 500k, and it makes me wonder what type of videos people love to stream, because people are streaming these videos where the person didn't even put any effort, they just took the video, they just put it in a video editor, changed the speed or reversed the song, and then they uploaded it, like they basically did nothing. And people are streaming these videos when they could put the time and effort into streaming K-tubers who actually put efforts into their videos, or streaming channels who actually put efforts into their videos, or checking out some underrated K-pop groups and giving them the views they need because they make amazing songs. I'm not saying that these channels who made these videos don't put effort into their videos, but I'm just saying that people could stream these types of videos less and stream actual good K-tube videos or YouTube videos or K-pop song videos that could get the channel, you know, more popular, get the group more popular, because these types of videos are getting streamed and then the actual good content on YouTube is getting overshadowed by people who make this content and they upload it and they get the views for it. So I'm saying that if you stream people who actually put effort into their videos, they could get more recommended to other people, they could get more views and more subs. I'm not trying to hate on these channels, I don't hate on these channels, because I've seen their other videos, the ones mentioned, and I've seen that they put effort into their other videos. I'm just talking about these videos by them in particular because they're getting views for something they barely even put an effort into. So I'm just saying that if people put their time and effort into streaming good content from the channels who make good content, then they could give them more views and more subs. Even if K-pop songs that they don't know about, they could stream those songs if they ever get recommended these songs, and they could give it more views because a lot of K-pop songs are below 10k, a lot of K-pop songs are below 100k, 1 million views, because even though they're amazing, they're not getting the views. So I'm just saying, but anyways, this was no hate to these channels, I just wanted to like share my opinion about why I hate these type of videos and why people could just put the time and effort into streaming something better. Before I start this opinion, I just want to say there's background noises in the video mainly because there's a party going on in our building and I can't really edit out the noises, so I hope that you can, you know, get past the noises and watch the video. Now, this opinion mentions BTS and TXT, and I'm not hating on BTS or TXT in this opinion. I'm just saying an opinion that came up at the top of my head. So I don't really wish any unpopularity to BTS or TXT. I love TXT and I wish that BTS and TXT remain as popular as they are now. I do not stand by this opinion. So I'm just saying an opinion that came up at the top of my head. This opinion may or may not be true, I don't know, y'all tell me in the comments. The opinion is, if BTS weren't worldwidely popular as they are now and they still remained an underrated K-pop group like they were before, then TXT wouldn't be as popular as they are now. Before y'all come into the comments and, you know, send me hate comments and unsubscribe, hear me out. Big Hit had a girl group named GLAM before and around the time of BTS, I don't really remember. And They released good music and they got views, like they got views past million, they reached 5 million views. But just like Nature, Bandit, April, Cherry Bullet, Dal Shabat and all these type of groups, they weren't as popular as you'd expect. Because they were before BTS and they were before Big Hit became a big company. So they weren't as popular as per se A-Pink or, you know, Red Velvet or Twice or GOT7 or EXO, any of the popular groups. So I'm saying that if BTS remained an underrated group, possibly on the verge of disbanding because their company was unpopular and, you know, their company promoted them, but if they didn't, you know, gain worldwide popularity, then TXT wouldn't be as popular as they are now. Hear me out. Because see, BTS are a worldwidely popular group now. So if BTS released the songs that made them worldwidely popular, and if like the people didn't stream BTS and BTS remained unknown, then Big Hit would go more into a loss as BTS would be disbanding because, you know, the fans are not streaming their music. And Big Hit would end up losing more and more money day by day because the fans are not coming in and, you know, supporting BTS. So then Big Hit would try later with TXT. And if TXT did the same thing, they made high quality songs and the fans didn't stream, then they wouldn't also get fans and they would also disband and Big Hit would end up, you know, shutting down and going into a loss. Since I say this is because Big Hit have become a big company because of BTS and BTS have helped them so much financially, and that Big Hit have become a big company and they've acquired, you know, Pledis Entertainment, they've acquired Source Music, they debuted a boy group in Hyphen, and also they will plan on debuting a girl group sometime next year or in 2022 after Glam Scandal. So this proves my point, because if BTS weren't worldwidely popular and they released the same music that got them worldwidely popular but fans didn't stream, then they would disband and the company would go into a loss. And then if TXT debuted and went down the same road as BTS and, you know, failed in the music scene, then they would also disband. And this is why I say that TXT wouldn't be as worldwidely popular now if it weren't for BTS. I do not stand by this opinion, I just gave an opinion that I thought of at the top of my head, so please don't come and hurt me in the comments. And please be respectful, this was just an opinion I thought of because I wanted to keep my opinions new and original. So yeah, this was all for this opinion, let's go on to the next opinion. I hate it when YG releases amazing songs for the group and then adds a, you know, dark sound to it one part and ruins the whole song. Like take Blackpink's Forever Young and See You Later, and take Treasures, I Love You and Boy. Those songs could have been amazing because they had amazing verses, amazing instrumentals, they were super happy, super fun. Then all of a sudden, the beat drops came for See You Later, I Love You and Boy, and they were dark and annoying and they really ruined the songs for me. Even with Blackpink's Forever Young, the beat drop was amazing. But then towards the end, when they were like, da tune come tune 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 party, na 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 na, we like to party. That part really ruined it for me towards the end. And I hate it because Blackpink always, YG always likes ending a song on a scary note or adding a scary beat drop, which totally ruins the song for me, and I can't really listen to Boy, I Love You, Forever Young and See You Later as much as I used to. I still love See You Later though, but like the other songs I can't really listen to as much anymore because these beat drops are really annoying and they really ruin the song for me. And this is the main reason I don't want to stan Treasures yet, because I don't stan boy groups as much and I've never stan a boy group properly before, and also because these songs could have been amazing but YG ruined them for me, leading me to not stan, and I will slowly not like them anymore because of this main reason. Yeah, so that's why I don't like YG ruining songs with dark sounds. Ignore the background noises, there's a party going on in our building as I said earlier, and the music is so loud. So the next opinion is, I like Lisa rapping in English more than Korean. When I heard Lisa rap in Bumbaya, As If It's Your Last, Whistle, Do Do Do, etc. I liked it, I liked her rap, I liked it. But they weren't as amazing as I thought, and like I didn't feel so like, wow, she's such a good rapper. But then when I heard her rap in Kill This Love, and then Love Sick Girls, than crazy over you and then love to hate me. I felt more connected and I was like, she raps so amazingly in English. Even though English is not her first language, she pulls it off amazingly. Even in really, like, yeah, I really was one of my favorite raps by Lisa in English until I heard Love to Hate Me. Love to Hate Me's rap is like out of this world. Her rapping skills in English sound so clear and amazing that I wish that she would do amazing as an English rapper, because her Korean raps are not for me, except for Ice Cream, which is my favorite Korean rap of Lisa's. But her English rapping is like so amazing, super clear, super perfect, and I love it a lot. And I wish that YG would give them more English raps. Yeah. Before I begin, I just want to say stand real for CSK and oh my god, they debuted in August, I think, with Wake Me Up, and this song is amazing. It makes me feel like I'm on drugs. It's like a Zimzalabim type of a concept, a weird song. And before I begin with this opinion, I just want to say a lot of video editors, video makers, video producers, video analyzers, and people who react to a song and react to the MV also and see every color, every detail, every prop, every scheme of the MV and everything, they will disagree with me. This is just an opinion, which I don't know if y'all agree with me, but if y'all agree with me, then well and good, but if y'all don't, then you can tell me why in the comments. The opinion is, no K-pop girl group or no K-pop boy group or no person in any music particularly releases a bad MV. It's just the quality of the camera. Now, I say this because I've seen underrated K-pop groups. Since I'm mostly a girl group fan of underrated K-pop and popular K-pop, I've noticed like groups like Avril with their song Wake Me Up and QoS, which is Queen of Sound, with their song Find a Way. Those are both debuts, and I've noticed that the quality of the camera wasn't amazing, but the way they shot the MV, the company shot the MV, was really good. Like, they got different scenes in the location they shot at. They got some good angles of the members, some solo angles of the members, solo scenes of the members and everything. And it was pretty well done, even if the quality of the camera was low. So I feel like the quality of the camera is the main reason groups don't get fans. Because if you look at other groups like White Day, Shine On Light, and Blue Foxes, Wake Me Up, it was just like a performance only of them dancing in one room. But in Blue Foxes, Wake Me Up, they had some solo member scenes, while in White Days, they just had them dancing. And the quality of the camera was better then. And even though it was just a performance MV, it was still a good MV, even if the quality of the camera wasn't amazing and wasn't super, super high quality. So that's why I say that groups don't release bad MVs, it's just the quality of the camera. There are a lot of underrated groups nowadays who are releasing good MVs, like Neon Punch Not Promoting Azam, We Girls, Botopass, Girl Crush, and they're getting views for it and it's really amazing. And I believe that girl groups and boy groups, or any sort of groups in particular, who don't get the views they need, is mainly because of the quality of their camera, not their MV. That's why I think that it's the quality, not the way the MV is made. As a stan about underrated and popular K-pop, I've said that I don't care about MV quality and I only care if the song is mixed in properly. But if a company who has an amazing budget and every time they can produce good MVs, why can't they give a group a good MV? Like Fantiago is an entertainment that had Hello Venus and promotes Astro and Vecchi Mecchi now. But two songs of Vecchi Mecchi, that is Dazzle Dazzle and Oopsie, weren't such terrible quality for MVs. Like, it wasn't the expectations of what Fantiago puts out. And if you look at Astro's Knock, it was a more amazing MV and a more higher budget. And if you look at a company like Volume Entertainment, and they give high quality MV to Rocket Punch for their song Juicy, but when Lovelies released the song Obliviate, the quality wasn't as good as you expect from Volume Entertainment. And I'm not saying that Fantiago and Volume don't give good MVs to Lovelies or Vecchi Mecchi, because if you notice Vecchi Mecchi's song Tiki Taka, or the recent comeback Cool, the MVs were so good. Or if you look at even the song Picky Picky. And for Lovelies, it's Lost and Found and Achu and all the other MVs. I'm just saying that if a company can produce a good MV for every group and has a budget, a big budget, every single time they produce an MV, why can't they give a good MV every single comeback? Why do they have to give a low quality MV for one comeback, like Lovelies Obliviate or Vecchi Mecchi's Oopsie and Dazzle Dazzle? It just annoys me at the fact that a good company can give a good MV but chooses not to for one comeback, and then the people don't stand because people don't because people want good MVs, and that's what I hate about people who want good MVs each comeback, or who want a good MV to stand a group, otherwise they won't stand. That's the main reason I get sad at groups not getting popular, because people want good MVs, and when a group doesn't have a good MV, then people don't stand. And then people don't stand, the group remains unpopular, and then nobody knows the group existed. And then whenever someone makes a girl groups you should stand video or boy groups you should stand video, people get shocked, like, I've never heard of this group before. Like, seriously, it annoys me. If a company can produce a good MV, they should, so that they could like get the group more fans, because people love good MVs and good songs. They don't just love a good song, they're not like me who doesn't care about MV. MV matters to them as well. QoS is Queen of Sounds, FAW, which is Find a Way, and The Singing Girls is This Night will remain one of the most underrated K-pop songs we ever released in K-pop. That is amazing and super high quality songs. Like, QoS's Find a Way has passed 1k views on their official channel and Super Soundbugs, while The Singing Girls is This Night has reached 12k on Ogam Entertainment. And it makes me wonder, why the hell are these songs super underrated? Like, The Singing Girls have disbanded. They were The Singing Girls before, a duo, and I think more members came, and then they rebranded into Melody Pink, releasing Hey You, and then they officially disbanded. And QoS debuted in 2020 with Find A Way, and it was amazing. Both these songs are amazing. Like, QoS is Find A Way, even though the MV wasn't high quality, the song was well produced. It's an EDM track, and it has amazing vocals, especially after the bridge when the girl has the really growly type of a voice and then she goes high. And The Singing Girls is This Night has even such powerful vocals that after the bridge they have the high notes and the belting and everything. And it makes me wonder how K-pop fans don't know these songs when they have everything they need in a K-pop song. An amazing, well-produced song with an amazing beat. It has amazing vocals, powerful vocals. It has an amazing rap, especially Rookie's rap in The Singing Girls is This Night is amazing. Nikki's also rap, I think it's a rap you could call it, in the second verse is amazing. Everyone sings so clearly and so amazingly in both songs, and this is amazing because these companies who formed The Singing Girls and QoS and debuted them made songs that were amazing. For small companies, it's really amazing to see how they can, you know, mix in powerful vocals so well, because a lot of small companies make amazing songs, but a lot of the times the songs are, you know, normal songs, and the girls or the guys singing are just singing normally with normal voices. But these songs were mixed in so well, like the powerful vocals were mixed in so well, you could hear the harmonies, you could hear the echoes, the vocal editing, everything. That's why I love these songs so much, and they have been put as my favorite songs in K-pop of all time. And you should check these songs out and give them your support. Well, give QoS your support because The Singing Girls disbanded, and stream both these songs because they're amazing AF. And yeah. So that's all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you didn't get triggered by these opinions. I know these opinions were long, but I had so much to say, and I wanted to add them all in one video because they were about, I think, 8 opinions or 7 opinions, and I didn't want to divide them into 2 videos because, you know, there'll be uneven amount of opinions. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you sub to me because I'm gonna make more videos soon. And yeah, so stay safe and wash your hands, and I hope you have a blessed and amazing Christmas, and I hope that the birth of Jesus brings you new life and brings you happiness on the 25th of December, because it's the 24th year where I live. And it's the afternoon time, and I'm gonna go for midnight mass, and I'm gonna celebrate Christmas with my family, and I hope you do too, and you have an amazing Christmas. Stay blessed, stay safe, and cue outro.